Adjustable gastric banding is an operation where we place a ring around the stomach. Here you can see a ring around the top of the stomach. This ring is attached to a tube and a port under the skin where we can inject fluid to tighten the ring around the stomach. This leaves a small pouch of top of stomach where we control the opening at the bottom of that pouch so food fills the pouch and empties slowly. The band needs to be adjusted to achieve the right diameter around the stomach so that food can go in and empty slowly, but not cause vomiting. The band is fairly effective if patients can eat small amounts, chew carefully, and slowly at achieving about 40% of your excess weight loss. Bands need to be filled until we get the proper adjustment, and that requires monthly visits in the first 6 months after surgery. During the operation, 5 small incisions are made, or sometimes we do this through the belly button with just one incision, and the band is placed around the stomach and stitched in place. Then the port, which it allows us to adjust the fluid level in the band, is placed under the skin and attached to the tubing of the band. So the entire system is implanted through 5 small incisions, and most patients go home the same day. Adjustable gastric banding is the simplest of all the weight loss operations. It doesn't involve cutting the stomach or intestines, it doesn't reroute anything, and it's reversible. So those are its main advantages. Those 3 things are offset, however, in some ways, by the fact that it's the hardest operation to learn to live with in some ways, because eating behavior really is restricted more than other operations. It has a reoperation rate of up to 30% in the long term. And the weight loss is the least of all the weight loss operations, about 40% of your excess weight. So if you're 100 pounds, you can expect to lose 40 pounds. Some will do better, some will do worse. The real issue is, will this be permanent for you, and will it achieve the amount of weight loss that you want? That's something you need to talk about with your doctor. Adjustable gastric banding is used for patients who fit the qualification for weight loss surgery. BMI of 35 to 40 with medical problems or above 40, even in the absence of medical problems. Hard to pick who's the best candidate for a band versus the other operations. Mostly it's either patients who are older or at highest risk, or patients who are unwilling to have one of the other operations because they're more complex. The amount of weight loss with adjustable gastric banding needs to be accepted. It's 40% or so, and you have to be satisfied with that result or else choose a different operation. Most patients who have an adjustable gastric band go home the same day, so I expect you'll go home several hours after surgery. After that, you'll be at home taking medication for pain for just a couple of days, and it takes about 2 weeks till you're ready to return to your normal activity and go back to work. Of course, the dietary changes are going on during that time, from liquids and purees to soft and then solid foods, pretty much the same as with any operation in the first 2 to 3 weeks. After any weight loss operation, you'll be meeting with a nutritionist, both before and after the surgery, to work on your dietary needs and expectations. After adjustable gastric banding, you're on liquids and pureed foods for 2 weeks, then soft diet for 2 weeks, and then finally regular food. By the second visit, at about 5 to 6 weeks, you'll be having solid foods, and at that point we'll make a decision about whether you're ready for an adjustment or need an adjustment of the band to make it tighter. The difference between banding and the other operations as far as diet is the band adjustments change your tolerance for food, so every time your band is adjusted, you're going to need to back up to soft and ultimately soft, solid, and then solid foods to get a sense for how the tightness of the band is and what you're ready to eat. Weight loss after adjustable gastric banding is pretty variable. Some patients really struggle to lose 20, 30 pounds. Some patients easily lose 70 or 100 pounds. On average, we see patients losing about 40% of their excess weight, which if you're 100 pounds overweight means about 40 pounds. The problem with this is it's really unpredictable.